Well, yes, I think a lot of us will be opting for being in the pool, being in the lake, or very close to it. It is going to be a hot, humid weekend, so we'll start things out with our cabin cast. So as we take a look around the region and what we're expecting, we do have some beautiful weather. Now, keep in mind, though, for folks up around Park Rapids, you do have that risk of some thunderstorms tomorrow and again on Sunday, but it is northwest Minnesota where we have the best chance for rain on both days. But as you move towards Brainerd, you're going to be waiting until late Saturday into the overnight hours into Sunday for your first chance there for some showers and thunderstorms. But take a look at those temperatures, a bit cooler on Sunday, and that is because of the cloud cover and some rain cooled air. But expect those 90s across the region. And for Winona, well, believe it or not, if you're in southeast Minnesota, parts of southwest Wisconsin, you're going to be waiting until probably late Sunday into Monday for that rain to reach you. It's a slow moving cold front. So again, you're going to have some pretty hot temperatures and you're going to want to be near that water very much so over the weekend. Temperatures outside right now, many of us just somewhere in the 80s, but it does get warmer as you get to the west, and that heat is really, really stacked up into parts of the Dakotas right now. But 90s out towards places like Moorhead and Ortonville. Strong south winds, good 10 to 20 miles per hour, just continues to feed the heat and the humidity. Dew points are climbing and they are all across the region in the 70s, nearly everywhere. So it will feel tropical. It'll be the air you can wear over the weekend, and it doesn't really show much relief even down the road. We're going to find ourselves somewhere in the mid and upper 60s, low 70s at times. So it is definitely going to be feeling like the middle of summer. There's our slow moving cold front, and it is going to take the better part of the weekend to get all the way through the region. In fact, by Monday morning, we may find it finally in parts of western Wisconsin. So it's not going to be racing through. But as you take a look at the severe weather potential along that cold front, it is going to be again to the very northwest for tonight into tomorrow. And then finally, as you go into Saturday evening, Sunday morning, we'll find it a little bit closer to cabin country. And then finally Sunday, making its way through the rest of the region. Like I said, that cold front's probably not getting through here until probably early Monday. So here's the microcast. And again, far northern northwestern Minnesota for tonight. Very limited chance of rain there. Saturday, we're going to wait until rather late in the day. Here we go, 11 o'clock at night, back towards Moorhead, quite possibly getting through cabin country during the overnight hours. Sunday morning, Alexandria, Brainerd, Grand Rapids direction. And then finally Sunday, it's going to make some progress south. Here's the middle of the afternoon, kind of west central, central Minnesota by 6 o'clock. Now we're going to talk about Duluth all the way down towards Marshall. And then eventually it could be quite possibly late Sunday night into Monday morning around the Twin Cities. So it will take a while to get all the way through here. Here's a look at the statewide temperatures for tomorrow. Just about everybody's going to be somewhere in that upper 80, low 90. Better chance of rain to the north, so a little rain cooled air there. But the feel like temperatures in the middle of the afternoon, all of us feeling like pretty much a mid and upper 90 for the better part of the afternoon, other than where you get some of that rain. And you can see the rain chances there for the metro really coming in into the later part of your Sunday, could linger into Monday as well. And then we're going to watch for another round coming our way Wednesday into Thursday. But all week long, it's high heat, high humidity.